In every city and town in the Republic of Mexico, there is a bull ring. And on Sundays at 4 o'clock, these bull rings come to life. Bullfighting holds a very important place in the life of a Mexican citizen. It is part of his culture and tradition. The owners of these bull rings or plazas, whether in large cities or small towns, are all interested in keeping their plazas filled. In order to do this, they must pit against each other the best man and the best bull that they can afford. There are many ranches in the Republic of Mexico that raise only one thing, fighting bulls. They are born and bred to fight. There are men who are trained to fight these bulls. They're called matadores or toreros. But being men, they're not born to fight. And they cannot be bred to be without fear. Our story begins on a Monday morning in November with three seemingly unrelated events. While a black bull named Brujo was looking for shade on one of these bull ranches, a famous bullfighter named Luís Bello, accompanied by his manager and cuadrilla, was boarding a train in Mexico City on his way to his first bullfight of the season. And at exactly the same moment, some 300 kilometers north, Eladio Gómez, the owner of a bull ring in the little town of Cuenca, was uneasily surveying his property and brooding about his dwindling business. Having reached no solution, he and his bookkeeper went to the plaza bar for a drink of tequila.
Are you there?
Good morning.
Good morning, Señor Gómez.
Tequila. Get two.
Wait a minute. Here's 200 tickets for the fight Sunday, Pancho.
Do you think he can sell them?
Business is not very good, Señor Gómez.
It could be better.
Yes, indeed, much better.
I do my best to give the people what they want.
At the lowest possible cost to your son.
Good bulls are hard to get.
Yes, they are expensive.
And toreros are not eager to leave the big cities to come to a little town like Cuenca.
La Pascua is not a big city. Next week in La Pascua, Luis Bello fights.
Luis Bello?
With La Punta Bulls.
La Punta Bulls.
Luis Bello, La Punta Bulls.
May I ask you, who lead off on the day of Santa Barbara?
It will be good. Somebody surprised.
Who?
Luis Bello.
Bello?
Luis Bello?
No.
Yes. The signed contract is in my office.
What bull is Eladio?
Well, I don't know yet. Maybe Las Astas or Buen Paso.
Bello deserves better than that.
Well, it's not all settled yet.
Have another drink?
No, no, no. I seldom take even a second before noon.
Thank you. At least a cigar?
All right, I have a cigar.
And excuse me,
I have to go.
The signed contract is in my office.
How much does Bello get per fight now?
More than you will pay.
Ah, oh, come on, how much?
30,000 pesos.
I didn't hear you.
You never hear when you don't want to. 30,000 pesos.
I heard. Too expensive. I promise.
$30,000.
little higher. This way is nothing much. Just 2 inches in the thigh.
How long will it take to heal?
About a week. Not more than two. No need to worry, Matador. You've had worse than this before.
Then we won't have to cancel the prisoner.
Cancel it.
The doctor said...
Cancel it! I'm tired. I want to go home. To rest.
Screamed? I had a bad dream. I don't know. Bulls, horns, coffins.
What time is it?
4:30. I only slept a couple hours. I'm all right now. I'm well, I'm ready. Where can I sleep?
What is it, Luis?
What is what?
Ever since you came home...
I don't know.
Maybe a few weeks in Acapulco in the sun.
I had too much rest already.
My coat.
I'll get him.
Fighting in the Plaza Mexico. You and me in the same car. Brother, I was good.
You'll get there. Go back to sleep, kid. You're always sharp. I wish I could sleep like you. Come on tomorrow. What are you waiting for?
Luis, telephone. Aguilar.
Telephone? Aguilar? Who? Long distance? Look, Jonita, you tell the man I'll be there as soon as I get dressed, eh?
Okay.
Corrale.
Angeli, Jonna.
Wait. Who could be calling you? Must be Raul. He's the only one who knows how to call me at Aguilar's. Wonder what he wants.
Listen, Ruiz, how'd you like to be on the guard in the Plaza Mexico this Sunday? Rojo got gored yesterday in Puebla and can't fight.
Gored bad? Malditos toros.
Look, Luis, this is a break for you. It'll mean an extra appearance for you in the big one. Same deal as your regular scheduled contracts there. How about that? What'd you say?
Nothing. I said nothing. I'm off my stride. I'm way off my stride.
Uh-huh. All right, Luis, I'll tell them no. Nobody can force you to fight.
No, nobody.
What shall I tell them? It's been a week since you fought, Luis. The public forgets fast.
Round up my boys for me. I'll catch the plane at Monterrey. I'll see you tomorrow, Raul. In Mexico City.
All right, tomorrow.
Many thanks, Don Casimiro.
My great pleasure, Don Luis.
That was my manager, Raul Fuentes. Rojo's been gored, and I'm taking his place in the Plaza Mexico.
Oh, splendid. I feel deeply bothering you with the detail at this time, my admired friend, Don Luis. But there is a matter of grocery bill that doubtless has escaped your attention. It amounts now to 4,000 odd pesos.
Hasn't my brother Alberto been taking care of the bill? I send him money for all such things.
No, he hasn't paid anything here since May. Ah, Don Luis, I am your attentive servant. Discussing this matter has given me pain.
It pains me too, but not in the same place. I'll send you a check from Mexico. Thanks for treating my mother with consideration.
What did the telephone say, son?
Where's Alberto?
He's still asleep.
Wake him.
Okay.
The telephone said nothing about Alberto. Nothing's happened yet, but it's about to. He's been using the money again. This time more than 4,000 pesos or aguilar since May. He's no brother of mine. Not anymore, he isn't.
What is wrong, brother?
I'm tired of muchos living in this house without shame.
Meaning who?
At this moment, meaning Alberto. It should be easy for you to name others. I'll kick them out. I'll sell this place and take you to Mexico City with me. And all these good-for-nothings, these relatives of a bullfighter around here can start scratching for themselves.
Just a minute, brother. Pepe's told me you're nothing to worry. I personally guarantee payment to Aguilar.
You personally guarantee with what? The money I make from the bulls? You personally guarantee. Pepe, get me my car. I want to get out of here before I lose my temper.
Just a minute, Pepe. My car's not here.
No? Where is it?
It's the garage for repairs.
What's wrong with it?
I had an accident, but it was a fortunate accident. Nothing happened to me. But the car's damaged.
Now, listen. Listen, you Alberto Bello. You professional brother of a bullfighter and disgrace to a name, you're through. I've had enough of you. Don't say you're sorry, you're finished. Now get your clothes out and get out of here. Get out! I'm glad you were all here. You saw it. It's about time. Everybody asking for money. You asked for money in my sling. I pay for this house, I pay for everything. With my flesh. The flesh I expose to the bulls while you get rocked with fat.
I'm sorry. None of this was for you. Not for Pepe. He understands. Not for Carmela. Not for anyone here. I'm sorry, Mama. The telephone call was from Raul Fuentes. This Sunday I'll fight in the Plaza Mexico, taking the place of a man who was gored. So my visit with you is ending. This afternoon I take a plane to the capital. Let's all have some breakfast together and finish our visit. Well, that's it. I guess I better go. Don't worry about a thing, eh, Pepe? I'll talk to Raul. He'll get something for you.
He better. I'm a matador without bulls. I got nothing to kill but time.
Don't worry. Raul's got irons in the fire, so have I. Thank you, Carmen.
If you get a chance, Manito, work with your sword. You're fine with your left, but I don't think you keep your right wrist quite straight. When you kill, you should not have
no,
a right Luis. Wrist.
No, please.
You say?
Fine.
Buenas noches, Maria.
Hey, do you hear me?
Yes, I hear you, Yank. Adios, Maria.
Rojo got the horns on Sunday.
Was he hurt bad?
Rojo? Very bad, Matador.
They say bad. Luis is taking his place Sunday in Mexico.
When do we do that, Matador?
Give me time, Peon. Luis is going to talk to Raul Fuentes. He's working on something for me.
Pepe, how long do we have to wait?
Do you think your car could make the trip all the way to Mexico?
What's on your mind, Matador?
To go to Mexico City.
Why?
I think I ought to talk to Raul Fuentes. After all, he's the manager. He makes the bookings. Besides, I'd love to watch Luis on Sunday.
Let's go.
How are we for money?
You?
Not much. But I think we can get some more. We'll go and see the Indio.
Hi, traveler. Welcome.
What goes, big agent?
How do you feel? Your leg, I mean.
My leg feels fine.
To the plaza, Tacho. They're unloading the bulls for Sunday. Want to take a look at them. Won't take long.
I see young Palacios is on the card. Why not my brother?
He comes from a big stable. They're pushing him fast.
And old Skinny Salazar.
I thought you'd like fighting on the same card with Skinny, even if his joints do creak.
He's getting awfully old, Skinny is, to be fighting bulls.
He needs the money.
Money.
Tacho, let's go.
Friends of bulls. Now, Raul, if you could only pack me up like that in a crate and take me into the ring on Sunday. In the bullpen.
Hola.
Margarita.
Tanto gusto.
How do you feel?
My leg feels fine.
How are you, Margarita? Hola. Gordo.
I had quite a job rounding up this so-called cuadrilla of yours. Monkey Garcia got thrown in jail Tuesday. 200 pesos fine. I got him out. This type of lad. He had to have wife trouble.
What did you do for him in that situation?
Have you seen his wife? These bullfighters, they only think of two things.
Who has time to think of bulls?
Anybody see the fight in Puebla when Rojo got the horns?
I was there.
Bad bull?
He got careless. Just as he went in for the kill, he got careless. He's not like you. He's a butcher with a sword.
What do you think, Tacho? You think I got careless in that last fight?
That was a bad bull.
They're all bad.
Lisa, I have a meeting. I'm sure glad you're home. Call you in the morning, we'll meet, huh?
Sure, Raul, call me in the morning. I'll take some supper, listen to the music on the radio, make myself some sleep. Tacho, drive Raul home.
What's the matter, Luis? Look, we've been together a long time.
You'll miss your date.
I can wait. Just some old friends. Dinner, a few spots afterwards.
The elite?
Oh, I forgot to tell you, I've got you booked for Medi on New Year's Day.
That's good.
Better terms than the last time.
That's good.
Oh, about your brother?
Yes?
I think something will break soon.
When?
It'll take time.
It didn't take long to get Palacios into the big ones.
Palacios had a few good fights.
Pepe is my brother.
If you want to push him fast, it'll take money for publicity. Lots of money.
What happens to all the money I make?
Good night, Luis.
Giving the elite a 10-peso tour?
Senor Luis Bello, I present my friends, Senor and Senora Sanchez.
Pleasure.
Senor Alvarez. And this is Linda de Calderon.
Linda de Calderon. And these are my two cousins. They came all the way from Querétaro. They want to see some interesting places. Did Raul tell you this was an interesting place, Senorita de Calderon? Raul knows all the people and all the places, from top to bottom, from bottom to top. Will you join me and my cousins in a drink?
I'd love to. Thank you very much. I'm very glad to have met you and your cousins.
Thank you.
dame la oportunidad.
Torea bien, ¿eh?
Sangue, ¿eh?
I've been waiting for you for 4 hours. I must see you. I must talk to you.
All right, come on.
That's how it happened. I swear.
You're a very bad businessman, Eladio.
I think with my heart.
Where do you keep it, in your pocket?
Who talks about money?
I do.
How much?
That comes later.
Later?
First we talk about something else. I think I can get Luis to fight if Pepe's brother fights with me.
Pepe Bello.
That's right, mano a mano.
How much for Pepe?
That comes later too.
Everything comes later.
Yes or no? No Pepe? No Luis?
And what you want me to do? You got me by the horns.
Come on. Now you wait here for me, huh? And leave it to me. Fight your way through, huh? Still the great Bello. They've been out there 24 hours.
That's very nice.
Gaona says there won't be a seat left for Sunday. I sent Pacho out to look for you.
He found me. What do you want?
Oh, I want you to sign the contracts for Sunday.
Are they all right with you?
Fine.
All right. I'll sign them.
Hey, you had quite a bit of drink last night, huh? Where did Thatcher find you? Turkish bath or confession?
I'm saving up for confession.
Nice training for Sunday.
Don't worry. I'll work with the calves tomorrow. Say hello. About last night at the house. I was on edge. But I said forget it.
It's already forgotten. Come in. Well, if it is my old friend Eladio Gómez. Luis, you remember Eladio?
Gómez, the little man? What brings you to Mexico?
It's so great an honor, Luis.
He hasn't grown an inch since I last saw him.
I'm getting older.
And smarter.
And richer.
What's on your mind, Eladio?
Only one thing, to have my plaza, my little plaza, which only holds 3,500 people.
5,000.
Honored by the great matador, Luis Bello.
Didn't you tell him no?
Oh, 10 times.
This makes 11.
I came all the way to Mexico, hombre.
Enjoy the sights and go home, hombre.
The fight's gonna be held on Santa Barbara Day, Don Luis, your patron saint.
We fight for money, not for saints.
Money's no object.
No?
Within reason.
Well, of course, we wouldn't consider fighting in Cuenca unless Pepe Bello was on the same card.
Well, in order to get Luis Bello, I'll be glad to make a concession.
My brother is no concession. He's a full matador. I don't want him fighting those goats either.
You don't have to worry about that. I'll get nothing but the best bulls.
The best, huh? Mm-hmm. I want San Mateo bulls.
San Mateo bulls? They were the best in Mexico. They were so expensive.
I'm sorry, little man. No San Mateos, no Bellos.
You drive a hard bargain, Don Luis.
So do you, or don't you remember? I fought for you once when I first started out.
But that was a long time ago.
But I still remember it. I remember many things about you and your bull ring, Señor Impresario. I fought in many places like yours, and they're all the same. Dirty holes for infirmaries, butchers instead of doctors, oxen for bulls, drunks throwing cushions and bottles. I fought in many places like yours, and I've got the scars to prove it. Once I had to, now I don't. Get me San Mateo bulls or go back to Cuenca, little man.
want some material, please?
Well, you really gave it to him, huh?
He needed it. That's all.
The car?
Still, if he buys the bulls...
They're blowing smoke.
No, I don't think so. There are many corners to this business, Luis.
That corner the little man won't turn. Too many pesos to step over.
Would be nice to see you and Pepe on the same card. Just the break he needs.
You're my manager. And friend. We'll leave early for the tienda tomorrow. Say, Raul.
Huh?
That girl, Linda. Have you seen her since last night?
No, why?
She stays in my mind.
Give them to me, Lala.
Which books?
The ones the Señor Fuentes brought here last night. They say everything about him, he said. I was going to read about toreros and know all about bulls. Come on, give them to me. Oh, don't go away, Lala. Come here. He's an attractive man, don't you think?
Yes, senora.
The drawing shows cruelty in his mouth.
Do you think it shows cruelty, Lala? Yes, senora.
He was most gravely gored in the left armpit. The horn would carry him to the door of death. I wonder what horn scars are like. Do you know, Lala?
No, senora. Hello? Who's calling? It's for you, senora. It's Luis Bello.
What are you thinking?
Nothing. When it's good, you don't have to.
Thank you.
Work again. How do you like all this?
Very much. It's the first time I've been to a tienta. Raul has been explaining it to me.
Raul's a good teacher.
Hey, look. Ole!
What's that?
Some crazy kid who heard about the tienta. They follow them like they follow circuses. They'll do anything for a chance at a bull or a calf.
I did that once. The boy's good. He's got courage.
Courage is not enough. He should have style like you. A thousand kids like him. Only one Luis Bello. Excuse me, I want to see Paco.
Only one Luis Bello.
Raul's a manager.
Raul used the wrong word. It's not style you have, it's grace.
That's from practice. You have beauty.
That takes practice, too.
Not your kind.
You know many beautiful girls.
None like you. Linda de Calderon. Good pick. That's a fine calf.
How can you tell?
By the way she charges. If a calf keeps charging the horse, it shows it has fighting spirit. She'd be the mother of a brave bull.
Don't you ever test a bull?
No, if we did, they might remember and charge the man instead of the cape. That's not good for bullfighters. We don't want any bulls remembering. No, a tienta is only for breeding purposes. It's a test for fighting spirit.
Who? The man's or the animal's?
Now it's the animal's. On Sundays at 4 o'clock, it's the man's.
Tiburcio, to be here in Santin is a great honor.
You must be tired.
Not the tired to discuss business. And bulls. Santin bulls.
They can both wait until morning. Now Cana will show you to your room.
In this room, in this bed, Manolete slept. En paz descanse. Good night, señor.
Good night. Manolete. Eladio Gómez. Here. In Santin. Where a bull cost 6,000 pesos.
There they are, my brave bulls. Talk softly, ride slowly. In a herd, they're not usually dangerous, but with a good bull, you never can tell. They are the result of 14 generations of breeding for bravery alone. They are born to fight. They have no other reason for existence, no other use on earth, except an instinctive desire to use their horns to kill whatever disturbs them. It is that desire that dies in them last of all. No detail of testing is spared at Santin. Notice the way that bull calf gets up and charges the horse again and again after he's been knocked down. That's a brave bull of Santin. That spirit, you hope, will show itself some Sunday afternoon in a plaza at 4 o'clock. But until that time comes, you never know. The strange thing about breeding bulls is that you never know how successful you've been until a few minutes before your bull dies. A man who has bred a brave bull has bred a quality without measure, a spirit that may be tested only in the destruction of it. This corrida is going to Plaza Mexico next Sunday.
Beautiful bulls. Must be very expensive.
Now, shall we talk business?
Yes, patron.
Well, you are looking for 4 number one bulls of Santin.
That's true.
But you cannot pay.
That's true, too.
I have something in mind for you. Look.
Don Tiburcio, you call that a bull?
That bull without a tail.
But this bull Brujo comes from the best cow in Santin. Look at the tienda. Special.
Special. I'm sorry that that I left. But looks funny, the whiskers, that tail. Like cartoon in the funny papers.
Well, all right. You know I cannot sell him to Plaza Mexico. They say he looks funny, too. I can make you this offer.
Yes?
You take this bull Brujo, and I will give you 3 other number ones to go with him.
How much?
20,000 pesos.
No, no, nothing like that, Don Tiburcio.
What can you afford?
15,000 pesos.
Oh, take the bulls for 16,000 pesos.
All right, I'll take them. That bull without a tail. Four o'clock. You got radio?
Yes, there it is.
Luis Bello is fighting right now in Mexico City. Come on, let's hear it.
We take you now to Mexico City and special announcer Jose Romero.
Sunday afternoon again in the Plaza Mexico, ladies and gentlemen. A beautiful day for what promises to be a beautiful corrida. Great crowds from all over the Republic are pouring into the plaza, eager to see their favorite toreros fight this afternoon. Today, Juan Salazar, Chato Palacios, and the incomparable Luis Bello match skill and courage with the fierce and brave bulls of Santa Marta. The ticket windows are doing a lively business, as are the women selling tacos and the men selling peanuts, because a corrida crowd is a hungry crowd, hungry for food and beer and excitement. Behind the scenes, there's a great activity in preparation for the dramatic event. The picadors are testing their lances as their mounts are being protected with heavy blankets because the horns of the bulls of Santa Marta are specially sharp. In the corrals, the bulls are being sorted and the fans are speculating which of the 6 will be the first and which will be the bravest and the most fierce. There are many people from other countries who do not understand our brave festival. To them, it is a sport. To us, it is not. It is an art, a ritual, a tragic drama in which the man is supposed to live and the bull is supposed to die.
The closer the matador works to the horns and the more style he maintains, the more the spectators share with him the experience of defying death with grace. No, bullfighting is not a sport. It is an ancient art designed to show the glory of courage over the power of death. Incomparable Luís Bello. Nothing very exciting has happened so far. Bello's work with the cape has just been adequate. No great style. He hasn't shown his usual bravery. He works away from the horns instead of close. This is not what the crowd has come for, and they are letting him know. The picadors, whose job is to bring the head of the bull down and tire him, are tiring him too much. Maybe that is what Luis Bello wants, but not the crowd. And the banderilleros, whose job is to enrage the bull, are planting too many sticks. The fight is being taken out of the bull. Well, now it's time for the sword and the muleta. Bello asks permission from the judge for the kill. He's dedicating the death of the bull to a very beautiful young lady. Maybe she will inspire him. And maybe at last we will see the Luis Bello of old, whose courage and skill all Mexico has learned to love and applaud. Torero like skinny to face. Because of the disappointment of the last fight, this crowd will make great demands. And Salazar is meeting those demands. Ole, Salazar! Ole! This is what we have come to see. That's courage. That's style. Ole, Salazar! Thank you.
Attention, all Mexico. Juan Salazar, beloved veteran matador of Teotihuacan, is dead. He died in the infirmary of the Plaza Mexico in the capital of the Republic approximately 3 minutes ago. Juan Salazar is dead. The nation's heart mourns. Rest in peace, Juan Salazar, torero.
Have some more taken later. Now, what else happened? I had the bull by the tail twisted. We did everything we could.
How about the public, Luis? What was your reaction?
The public.
You boys care for another drink?
No, thank you.
Salute.
Salute.
Boys, what about a picture over here? Luis, the boys want to know about the public.
The public? Who knows about the public? You, Paco? One day they whistle and hoot. The next day they want to kiss you and carry you around with flowers.
Has the public been any good to you, Luis?
Wonderful. I appreciate every filled seat in every place I fight in. So did Skinny Salazar. He told me many times. Skinny made one unfortunate pass. Landed him in heaven. The public liked it fine. They made him a hero. But the bull made Skinny dead.
Don't write it like that. You know what Luis means. He means that...
They know what I mean. The heart of the public is like a mountain ham. It takes a big knife to slice it.
He means the people are hard to please. They have very high standards. They make great demands. And the great torero supplies those demands.
Listen to this. All Mexico mourns and weeps at brave torero's death.
The whole bull crowd, reporters and all, give me a pain. They talk bigger and braver than any bullfighter that ever lived. And a two-year-old calf would scare the pants off them.
Are you just finding that out, Mano, after 10 years of Sundays?
I never thought much about it before.
Maybe that's what a bullfighter gets paid for. To sell a brave feeling to a man who hasn't got it. Has to buy it so he can talk about it. Like it belonged to him.
Salazar died broke, you know that, don't you?
Left a big house.
And a big mortgage.
Juan was never the torero you are.
He was pretty good. Smart with the bulls. But I want to be smart with the money. I spend too much, Raul. Will you help me? I don't know anything about money, but I need it. Now more than ever.
Now more than ever?
Will you help me be smarter? A real program. I'll listen.
You'll do all right. Sure, I'll help. If you're serious.
The horn was wet. Right up to the hair, wet and sticky.
Cut it out, Luis.
Meat for the bulls. That's what they say about me. They always have.
Yes? Yes, I'll hold on. Stop worrying, will you? There'll be plenty more Sundays when things will be different.
It won't take many more Sundays like this one.
What? No,
Hey, shut up, will you?
Well, Cuenca. Yes.
Hey, let's have some music. Real loud music. Not louder than that. You know, there are girls in Mexico City.
What did you think, there were only bulls?
And he knows them more. Now I know them more.
Yeah, fine. Hey! Congratulations, matador. You're fighting in Cuenca on Santa Barbara's Day with Luis.
No.
Cuenca?
Yeah, Cuenca. That was Eladio Gómez on the phone. He's got Santin bulls. Number one's four of them.
Luis, my brother.
Well, what are you doing? Crying or laughing? I never thought that peso pincher would do it.
He did it because he wants pesos. The Bello brothers and Santin bulls will pack the plaza.
Ladies and gentlemen, we interrupt this broadcast to play for the first time on the air a song just written to honor a great hero who died, specially composed by one of Mexico's leading creators of ballads. It is called The Tragedy of Juan Salazar.
Turn that thing off.
That's what I was thinking about.
Why do you do it, Luis? How can you go on doing that? Sunday after Sunday. Why do you do it, Luis? What for?
It's what I do, you know that. Luis Bello without bulls, nothing going back to nothing. But you saw only the bad. There is something to it. Something great about it sometimes. I wish I could show it to you then. I wish I could show you when it's good.
I haven't felt it for a long time. I don't know why. I try, I wish I could. But I didn't show you.
Luisito, you show me.
Will you go to a plaza again so I can show you?
It's important, isn't it, Luis?
It's what I do.
Look,
the next one here is 3 weeks from Sunday, the 18th. We'll make it a real one. One for Linda. And we'll celebrate after. What do you say?
We'll see. Tell me what you do till then, torero.
Day after tomorrow to Guadalajara.
How long will you be gone?
I'll be back Monday. And you, what will you do till then?
I'll be here. Or maybe I'll go to visit some friends in Cuernavaca.
I'll leave you my car.
Will the corrida in Guadalajara be prominent?
Not so prominent, but Raul thought I would take it. Raul thinks it's important for a matador to keep his name before the public, even in the provinces. But the next one here in the plaza, the one I told you about, that'll be the good one. Raul's going to Piedras Negras this weekend to select the bulls. They'll be serious ones.
Are they all serious?
The brave bulls with the breed in them are serious. Without them, the whole thing's a pity.
Tell me more. About bulls, Señor Bello.
Talk.
More yet.
Ay, Linda.
Oh, Luis, darling. I wish it could stay like this.
It's staying.
If everything would stay away like this. All gone away. Keep everything away, Luis.
Linda, don't cry.
I'm not.
There are some good parts. What's the matter? There are some good parts.
You're sure?
Sure, I'm sure. Even when I was a kid.
What were you like when you were a kid?
As a kid, I was always hungry.
I remember that more than anything else. Sometimes I stole. Mostly I worked for a few pesos a day. It made no difference whether I stole or I worked. I was always hungry. One day I saw a prince, a bullfighter. And I made up my mind. That was for me. From that day on, wherever there were bulls and bullfighters, there I was. I was always practicing, always working. Because I knew if I could be like that prince, I would never be hungry again. And I would always be proud. Then my father died, and we had to move to Mexico City. And I was glad, Linda. Because then I could see the world and show it. I became a bullfighter. But it wasn't like being a prince at all. It was rough. It was tough. It was dirty. And I thought I'd never make it. Until one day, I met Raul. Through the green years and the tender years, he took care of me. He showed me everything. He taught me how to fight and how to live. Whatever I am, Raul made me.
Raul made you.
I'm going to quit someday, Linda. They say the money you make belongs to the bulls. It's the bulls' money. They give it to you and they can take it back any time. It's not yours until you can walk away telling the bulls goodbye forever. Then if you got anything, it's yours. Manoleta had millions and the bulls took it back before he could walk away. But you know, there is something about the bulls. And the crowd, music, feeling what you can do. And the big afternoon.
Like some coffee?
Thank you.
Margarita, another cup, please.
Yes.
I went to your house.
I came over here to say goodbye to Luis.
Oh? We have a date to go to Cuernavaca today. Did you forget?
No, I didn't forget.
Are you ready?
I'm not going.
When did you change your mind? A moment of conscience?
Moment of truth.
Oh, I like truth when it's true.
This is.
That Luis Bello and...
And me.
That's not truth. That's fantasy.
Leave me alone, Raul.
Leave him alone.
A week ago, I would have been very flattered to think that Raul Fuentes could be jealous.
Raul Fuentes is human.
Go to Cuernavaca, Raul. All the bright and witty people will be there.
I'll get your coat.
I told you I wasn't going.
What are you going to do?
Wait. Wait here for Luis to come home from Guadalajara.
That's very touching, but why?
You know why as well as I do.
You see, Luis is not himself right now. He has fear. You don't understand that, do you?
Yes, I do. I understand it very well. I understand something else, too.
What's that?
You too glad he has it.
No, I'm worried about it. I'm his manager.
He thinks you're his friend.
I am his friend.
Yes, you're his friend. You get things for him.
Pretty things.
You take them away and you say to him, don't worry, Luis. Trust Raul Fuentes. He'll get you whatever you want. This you don't take away.
I don't have to. You'll go away. I know you, Linda. You'll go away like you've always done with all of them. The flyer, the painter, the actor. Because you've begun as a hunter in you. What about Luis when you go?
What about Luis?
He's looking for something to believe in.
He believes in me.
He doesn't know you. He's a peasant.
Like you.
Like me. Only I know you. I've got too many years in this boy.
At what percent?
Less than yours. He won't even be a good matador any longer. Right now, he only doubts himself in the ring. Then he'll doubt himself as a man. That's not good for Luis Bello.
Not for you.
Nor for me. He'll get over the fear that he feels now.
You're glad he has it. I know you are. It makes you feel good. It makes you feel better than he. You've wanted to feel that way for so long, Raul. That's why you won't let me go, because you know Luis wants me.
What's his is mine.
So you heard.
About what?
About the fight at Guadalajara.
Lisa, I'd like to ride home with you.
I'll ride by myself. See you at the house. What took all of you so long? What you have to say, you can say to me.
We have nothing to say.
Now you.
Yes, Mitch.
What's eating you? What's the matter? Somebody ram a sausage down your throat? It wasn't that bad.
Luis, could we?
Could we what?
Could we talk alone?
Well, come on, what do you want to tell me?
I've got to tell you something. It's Raul. Raul got killed.
Raul? He got killed in the car. In your car. Coming down from Cuernavaca on the mountain last night. Raul got killed? Pepe, listen, Pepe, how do you know that?
Oh, everything. The chief of police on the phone, and then everybody. It's in the papers this morning. And I was afraid, you'd see it before I could tell you, before I could get you home.
Raul? My right arm. Right, I'm gone.
Was anybody else with him?
Yes.
Dead?
Yes.
How many?
Just one besides Raul.
Who? What was his name?
It was a girl. Oh, Luis, my brother. And I have to be the one to tell you. The girl was Linda de Calderon.
With Raul? killed with Raul? In my car.
Luis, I...
No.
Get out, please. Go away. Get out. Get out.
You. Yes, sit down. Talk to me.
What's your work?
Yeah. You got work. I got nothing. Except the bulls, I'm through with them.
You better go to Luis.
Go?
Where? I got no place to go. They even smashed up my car. I got no place except the bulls. And I'm through with him.
Please, senor. I have to open soon.
Don't open. I want it to stay closed. I don't want anybody in here. I pay for everything. And I want it quiet.
Quiet.
Quiet! Linda! Linda!
Linda!
Linda.
Linda. Linda. No. No, you're not Linda. Linda. Linda, I had troubles. I never knew what. I'll never know now at all. Help. Linda, that was beautiful. The real Castaner. Who was someone? Did you know Raul? Answer me, I asked you a question. Did you know Raul?
I know many Rauls.
But none like this one. Raul, he was my right arm. Old Raul. My sword arm, and I lost him. What do you think?
I'll get you drinks, senor.
I asked you what to think.
I don't.
Linda and Raul, did they really do it to me? I wanted to know. Maybe they didn't. I hope I never find out. But I'll think. I'll think. I'm Torero.
I know, Senor Bello. You are very famous.
A Torero has no fear.
You are very brave, Senor.
You think so?
So they say.
Well, I'm not. I'm afraid. I'm afraid of the horns. Afraid of all the horns. One of the horns is Linda dead. Another of the horns is Raul dead. Still another one. It's Linda and Raul together alive. That's the horn that cuts and tears.
I'm Torero.
So you told me.
And you? Who are you?
Raquelita.
Raquelita. A pretty Raquelita.
You want to see the way I fight the bulls? Come on.
on, Lachimita. You're the bull. Come on.
Where is Luis?
Look, he's not seeing anybody.
Why
he's
not
feeling well. I'm sorry.
Where were you?
Yes? No, Señor Gómez, this is Pepe. Pepe Bello. No, Luis can't come to the phone right now. I can't find him. No, I mean, he can't come to the phone right now. Well, he's not feeling well. He's upset.
Pepe, I feel deeply for the tragedy of Fuentes. Accept my sympathies.
The contract.
Shut up, will you? I call about the corrida Sunday. I want to make sure of my contract.
Of course Luis will fulfill the contract.
I want to know from Luis himself. The cartels, the bulls, the corrida, in 5 days only. Man, I got to know.
Naturally, naturally, Señor Gómez. You go ahead. We'll be there. If I ever find him.
Don Luis Bello, is he here?
Yes, what do you want?
Don Luis Bello, is he here?
I'll say he's here. You get your torero out.
Where is he?
He's in my room.
Why, what's wrong?
What's wrong? Look.
What happened?
What happened? Oh, what happened?
Did he drink much?
Did he drink much?
Did he pay?
Yes.
I'll say he paid.
He told me to take whatever it cost. The damages were terrible. Come back again sometime, boys. But you better not come back like bullfighters.
This part of the country. What's it like?
Dry and lonesome. Very dry and very lonesome.
Luis, please, I'm sorry.
What are you sorry for?
The fight tomorrow.
What about the fight?
Well, I know you're fighting because of me.
Of you? You're wrong, Pepe. I took this fight because I wanted it.
Thank you.
I arranged with the connected rooms for you and your brother. I thought you would like to be close together to the Scotch play.
A lot of noise.
Night of fiesta. The people come from the whole district for today and tomorrow. There will be a little noise, but you will rest well.
Very good. The bulls are here, the expensive ones from Santin.
Beautiful.
Why?
Don't you know when you're around bulls, you have to talk softly?
Excellent, really, number one.
Too bad about number 23. He looks like a buffalo.
Did you see the way they charge? He's got something behind those whiskers. Casta. That's true. Casta. That's what he got from the best cow of Santin.
But he's got no tail.
Do you think a bull fights with his tail?
Look proud and brave.
the suit will hide your fear. Or will it? What is it you're really afraid of? Dying or living?
I'm dry. Bring me water. I'm very dry. High wind. That's why that's Salazar. All right, Tacho.
Virgin of Guadalupe, Queen of Mexico, and my sweet mother. Give me the grace of thy protection and the good luck. Save me from the horns of the beasts, that I may venerate thee to the end of life. Amen. is a house.
Here it comes. Here it comes.
You gotta get to the infirmary.
Bring his sword, please.
I dedicate this bull to you, Luis. Because you are my teacher. Because I owe you everything.
Thank you, Manito. Have luck.
Thank you.
It comes as God wants it.
Not bad.
Please.
Thank God. He's ready to come again.
Tell him not to be crazy. They got to sew him up.
When you run.
I'm not running.
I dedicate this bull not to you out there, but to what I know now. That a man cannot live in fear.
Let's do it. Now. Only we know. They don't. Only we know what it's like to stand here and look at death right in the eye. Let's do it now. With courage and with style. Come on, death. Brujo!
Come on, kid. Look at them. Look at the girls.
smiling now. Whole world's ours. Come on, kid. You and me. We'll live forever and both get rich.